हेलो गाइस, सो लेट्स डू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज डीएनए. डीएनए यू शुड नो दैट इट इज अ डबल हेलिक्स स्ट्रक्चर. डबल हेलिक्स मींस इट हैज टू स्ट्रैंड्स. ओके, डबल हेलिक्स मींस इट हैज टू स्ट्रैंड्स व्हिच आर कॉइलिंग ऑन वन अनदर. ओके, if you look at this picture then you can understand this helical structure. This is called as helical structure. Okay, and it is double helix because this is one strand and this is another strand. Okay, the next point that you should know regarding DNA is that DNA is DNA, or sometimes they give you as chromosome, or in the question they can give you as nuclear chromatin. It is binded by histone proteins. It is binded by a protein called as histone proteins. So it is very important for with Kroc point of view that instead of DNA they can give you chromosome or nuclear chromatin, and they will ask you who binds them. Then the answer is histone proteins. Another important question regarding DNA is they ask inversion. Now inversion is turning of DNA to 180 degree. If DNA is turned 180 degree, then we call it as inversed DNA. Okay, it is called as inversion. Now let's know about bonds of DNA. So for a DNA to be formed, there are three important bonds. So first let's know them. Between bases there are hydrogen bonds. Now between bases, what are bases? Bases are nitrogenous bases, which could be either purine or either pyrimidine, which can be purine or which can be pyrimidine. Purine have a 6 or 5 membered ring. Nitrogen containing ring, whereas pyrimidine has only 6-membered nitrogen containing ring. Okay, now let's know the example of purine. Purine are adenine and guanine. Pyrimidine are cytosine and thymine. Now this thymine, it is present in DNA, but in RNA thymine is replaced by uracil. So but in RNA uracil is present instead of thymine. And the hydrogen bonds which I was talking about, it is formed between purine and pyrimidine. So adenine from purine forms a double hydrogen bond with thymine, and if it's RNA then adenine of purine will form a double hydrogen bond with uracil. Okay, the another bond is formed between guanine, which is a purine, with cytosine by 3 hydrogen bonds. So adenine and thymine by 2 hydrogen bonds, HB is hydrogen bond, guanine and cytosine by 3 hydrogen bonds. You can look here, 2 hydrogen bonds and 3 hydrogen bonds. Okay, so these are the bonds which are present between the bases. The second bond, type of bond which is present in the DNA, is between sugar and phosphate. Between sugar and phosphate, the type of bond is covalent bond. Now among covalent, the exact name is phosphodiester bond. Now you should know this phosphodiester bond, it forms backbone of DNA. Very important point, that which bond forms the backbone of the DNA. The answer is phosphodiester bond. The third bond is, which is present in the DNA, is between the sugar and the base. The bond is ester bond. The bond is ester bond. So let's look at all the three bonds in detail. I have drawn this very simplified diagram which you also have to draw. So let's name all the bonds. Okay, first let's start with hydrogen bond. So hydrogen bond is present between the two bases. So this is one base, this is another base, right? So the bond in between them is the hydrogen bond. ANT, adenine and thymine, is bonded by 2 hydrogen bonds. Go on in cytosine by 3 hydrogen bonds. Okay, so this is hydrogen bond between two bases. Now let's look at the covalent bond. The covalent bond or the phosphodiester bond. So this is the sugar molecule, right? This is the sugar molecule and this is the phosphate. You can see this bond, this pink colors which I have drawn. This is the, so this pink color bond which you're looking at is the phosphodiester bond. Phosphodiester bond forms the backbone of the DNA and it is present between the sugar and the phosphate group. Okay. The third bond is the ester bond. Ester bond is present between the sugar molecule and the bases. So this bond, this red color bond, is your ester bond, present between a sugar molecule and the base. Okay. So you have to remember all these bonds in detail. Now there come, we have always heard about that DNA is formed of nucleotides. Okay. So let's know what it means by nucleotide. So nucleotide is your sugar plus phosphate group plus base. So all these three things which you saw over here, the sugar, the phosphate, the base, all these three things together forms a nucleotide. Okay. So you should remember the meaning of the nucleotide and you should remember the bonds present in the DNA. So that's it. Thank you.